back, everyone. So what we're gonna do today is we're going to review the brand new horror comedy released like a few days ago. If you have been around my channel, you know how I do movie reviews. I separate them into different aspects, so things that I liked and dislike, things that I will improve, and I will talk about stuff like the cinematography, the characters, the storyline, the plot, if like the movie portrayed what it wanted to give, and all of that. And also, this review will contain spoilers, but I will let you know when the spoilers are coming up.
So, The Menu, directed by Mark Millot. Wonderful surprises await you all. A couple travels to a coast island to eat an exclusive restaurant where the chef has prepared a lavish menu with some shocking surprises.
So just before I go into this review, I just want to say that I'm really happy that I love this movie, because obviously this is a comedy horror and I'm not the biggest fan of comedy horrors, as you know me. So I came into this movie with a very open mind, and I'm happy that I left the theaters feeling good about it. And also, I want to do something different this time. I want to talk about first about the negative aspects from this film, because there are not so many, so I want to get out of the way with those. So the first negative aspect that I think this movie has is that even though it has so many characters, I think this movie doesn't have enough kills. And I think the plot and the storyline could have worked so well with some kills. And also, I wish I could have seen more gore, but obviously I don't complain too much about those, because I think the kills and gore was not something that The Menu was going for. And also, another negative aspect that I found about The Menu is some dialogues and some lines that are very questionable, and also with the acting. Some acting from some side characters is honestly not the best, but it didn't take me out of the storyline, because thankfully our lead, our antagonist, the actor acting was so good. And also, when it comes to the lines, it does make sense why some lines are very awkward and weird, because at the end of the day, this is a comedy. We're going to talk more about that into the storyline part of this video. And surprisingly, those are like the only negative aspects that I have about this film. If you have more negative aspects, I would love to read them down below. Now, when it comes to the positive aspects about this film, the first one that comes to mind is obviously the characters, because I think the characters are so, so well paced, especially our leads, like our main couple, our antagonist. And I think I'm not alone when I say that. I felt identified with Anya Taylor's character so much because of the way she was reacting, the way she was looking around this environment, and just overall I really felt identified with her, because honestly, if I am in a situation like this, I will 100% react and do the things that she did. And also, like I said before, the antagonist, I think this villain is like, first of all, it's very natural and it's very realistic, because so many chefs out there, I'm not trying to blame that career because obviously it's very hard and stuff, but many people out there, and not even chefs, like many people out there with like very high ranking at their place, they act like this guy, like they think they're superior, they don't really listen to anyone. So I do think this character is so well written, and I think it's a great, great villain for this movie. Another positive aspect that I have about this movie, and we're going to talk more about that into the storyline part of this video, is that I loved the storyline and how it goes throughout from the beginning to the end. Which brings me to the part that I really appreciate how this movie took the risk to not really have a beginning, because this movie literally starts with our characters going to this restaurant, if that makes sense, like on their way. And I did appreciate that, because if this movie would have explained so much about the characters, I think it would have dragged. And obviously, the main positive aspect that I found about The Menu is the satire, the social commentary. I think those two work perfectly combined together, because obviously it's not a secret that, and we're going to talk more about that into the storyline, but it's not a secret that these kind of restaurants or these kind of places, they don't even have to be the restaurants, but like this kind of environment is very toxic. And I think the movie played so well with that, which brings me to the point that this movie, I love that it was so self-aware and in such a good way, because the movie knew what it was doing, the movie knew how corny it was, the movie knew the kind of satire that it was giving to society and like to people in general. Now, let's start talking about characters, storyline, cinematography, plot, and at the end I will give an overall on how I felt about this movie. So when it comes to the characters, I'm briefly gonna talk about our main character, her partner, like some side characters, and obviously our antagonist. So when it comes to the main character, Anya Taylor, I have to say that I absolutely loved her for the stuff that I said before. But one of the main reasons why I really liked it is because she has personality. Sometimes in comedy, the characters are so dumb, they don't feel realistic. And that's one of the main reasons why I don't really appreciate comedy. But in the menu, Anya Taylor's character, it feels like someone real. Like, you can find this person in a real place. I felt identified with her. I know many people have felt identified with her. So I'm gonna talk about her partner and the side characters combined, because I think there are so many interesting stuff to say about them. Because obviously those characters are the perfect satire to some people in today's society. For example, Anya Taylor's character, partner, I think he was a perfect social commentary to the people that live behind social media, the people that depend on social media, that wants to like be someone that they don't really are. Because as we know, this character, he struggled to get a reservation on this restaurant, and he just wanted to do that so he could like portray or wanted to be someone that he really wasn't. He wanted to demonstrate that he was rich when obviously he wasn't. And obviously there is one scene where he takes a picture of every single plate, and it's like, in society we all do that. Like, when people go to fancy restaurants, to fancy places, they take pictures of their food plates and they post it on social media. And the main reason, and we all know that, the reason why people do that is because they want to portray something that they really aren't. Because I know, and I'm sure, when people go to fancy restaurants, they either save money or they really struggle with that. If people go to restaurants because they are rich and stuff, okay, fair enough. But we know that the majority of society, we don't really are very, very rich. And many people out there are very, very fake on social media, like Anya Taylor's character, partner. And also some side characters, for example, there is a rich couple, and I really like the satire behind those characters, because those characters were basically trying to be clever just because of they were talking about the food. And I think that was really fun, because some people out there in society, they really think just because they use some posh words or just because they describe food differently, they are somehow superior. But we know that's not real. Like, we know that's stupid, in my opinion. And not only with like food, I think this had a good metaphor. And the perfect example is that, for example, this rich woman on the movie, she's saying stuff like, I'm feeling like the food is tasting like air, like waves. That's how I'm portraying it. And if people don't realize that the food tastes like waves, they don't really enjoy the food. And that was a perfect metaphor and satire, for example, in the filming community, in the horror community, when people say stuff like, if you don't see a horror movie this way, it's because you didn't understand it, so that means you're stupid. You know what I mean? So I really like that, how those two characters were such a great example for like those people that want to be superior out of everyone else just because they use different kind of language, or just because they move differently or act differently in different kind of places. The rest of the side characters, they were quite funny. And also I really like the other group of chefs, because it's not a secret that in this industry, or like in very popular industries, or like in a very demanding industries, especially in hospitality, I really like the satire behind the other mini chefs, let's call them, because it's not a secret in hospitality, you really have to work like an animal. Like, I've worked in hospitality before, and honestly sometimes you really feel like an animal or like a slave, because it's like you have to do things so quick, like in so less time. You have to have someone shouting at you that you become like kind of blind to what's around you. And I really like that metaphor. Now let's talk about our antagonist. And like I said before, I talked about him briefly before in this video, but another stuff that I want to add about this character is that I think this was such a great commentary and satire about toxic managers, toxic bosses in hospitality. Because like I said before, I have worked in hospitality before, and trust me when I tell you, I have had many horrible bosses, many horrible managers, many toxic, passive-aggressive, and that's the way this guy is. And I think I've dealt with people like this in the past. So that's, I think that's why this movie hit me in a different way. Now, briefly talking about the storyline, I have to say that obviously, like I've said many times on this video, I love the satire and I love the metaphors. Now, I have to say that for some reason, I thought it was going to be a slasher, or I thought it was going to involve the cannibals. But I don't know, I just don't know what I thought that, but I'm glad to be honest that it didn't involve that, because I think one of the main things that I loved about The Menu is that this movie really relies on a storyline, characters, metaphors, and satire. And I absolutely love that, because it's not a secret that sometimes many movies out there, they rely on gore, blood, kills, and not much on the storyline. But The Menu does the opposite. It doesn't have many kills, it doesn't have many gore, but because the storyline is so strong, the metaphors are so strong, and the characters are so strong, this movie really works perfectly just because those three aspects are so well connected. So one thing that I really liked about storyline is that it's non-stop, that it's like something is always going on, and it's because we have a 5-plate menu on this movie, so obviously every single plate is something different, so you're always looking forward on what's gonna be the next plate, what's the next lines that our villain is gonna say. Obviously, we want to see what Anya Taylor's character is gonna do. So I think one of the best aspects about the storyline is that it's non-stop. It's always something that's going on. Your eye was always captured. And if you add some jokes, some funny jokes, some funny moments from those characters to that, it's a great perfect combination. And I think that's why this has become one of my favorite horror comedies now. Moving now to the cinematography, I have to say that I absolutely love the color grading of this film. I think this movie looks so gorgeous. I think this movie knows how to work with like bright and light colors. For example, the whites, the light orange, the yellows, like the purple, pinks, the red. I think it was so good that Anya Taylor had red hair and a purple dress. Her skin is very white, so having her with three different colors was so like good looking for the movie. I also really liked how the rest of the characters, they don't really have many bright colors because they want Anya Taylor to stand out, because obviously she is our character. Now, one of the main things that I loved about the cinematography is the use of reverse shots. And in case you didn't know what a reverse shot, it means that when many people or many characters are experiencing the same thing, in this case, all of those characters were in the same restaurant, eating the same food, interacting with the same villain. But obviously, as you saw by the movie, each character, like each couple and stuff, they were experiencing many different things. So, for example, the Anya Taylor character and her partner, when like both those two characters were totally different, and when the food came to the table, obviously Anya Taylor's character partner, he immediately started to eat so quick. He was taking pictures and stuff. He was saying that like the chef was like a god, that he was feeling like he was in heaven. And that was shot from like Anya Taylor character point of view. And at the same time, the reverse shot was the same thing, the same food, the same storyline, the same theme from the movie, but that time from Anya Taylor character partner towards Anya. I really hope that explanation about reverse shot makes sense, because I think it gave so much personality to this movie, because many characters did that, like for example the rich couple, the trio, also the older couple, the Latin couple, all of them, they have reverse shots. Now, and this is like mostly the spoiler part of this movie, so I have to say that I love the ending, especially because Anya Taylor's character, I really like the way she starts to play around with the chef, with the storyline, with the characters. And she immediately, the last few scenes, I just felt identified with her so much, especially when she's craving a cheeseburger, because even though she has been eating for the last 5 hours, she's so hungry. Love that last scene where Anya Taylor's character is eating the burger at the boat. And like obviously the restaurant is on fire, and Anya Taylor is like, fuck it, I don't really care about this, and I'm just enjoying this. I absolutely love that in this mini scene. And so yeah, that was my review of The Menu. I really hope you enjoyed this movie. I really recommend it so much. It's out of the theater. This movie came out like 4 days ago. So if you're nearby a theater that is screening it, I would really recommend to watch this movie. obviously, if you're a fan of comedy, this movie will be for you. But obviously, if you are not like I am, please, please give it a chance, because I think the comedy works so good with the horror, because this is still a horror movie, but obviously it's more heavy on the comedy side, but both work so, so good. So I would really, really recommend this. Let me know what you think about the menu in the comment section below. I would love to read every single comment about this movie. I would love to interact about it. I really hope you enjoyed this movie, and I really hope you enjoyed this review. I will see you in the next video. Have a nice end of the week, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.